Hello. In the previous video, we talked about a serial bus and how it uses a single wire to transmit data. In this lesson, we will look at the parallel bus. For a while, parallel communication was the preferred choice when sending data. The principle is a simple one. Use multiple wires to transmit simultaneously. So if you have a parallel bus consisting of 8 wires and a piece of data the size of 8 bits, you could send all of it in a single clock cycle, whereas it would take several clock cycles to send the same size of data using a serial connection. So with parallel buses, more lanes equal higher throughput rates, which means faster transfer. This thinking was felt in many aspects of early computers. From the internal circuitry to connecting peripherals, all relied on the parallel bus. But there are drawbacks to what may seem as nothing less than an elegant solution. Parallel buses do not only take up a lot of space because of their many wires, they are also costly, especially for lengthy connections. And speaking of length, the longer the cable is for a parallel bus, the greater the chances are for crosstalk, which creates interference. This setback forces data transmissions to operate at slower clock speeds. Eventually, the drawbacks were becoming more obtuse than the benefits of parallel communication. And as high-speed serial technologies like USB came onto the market, the dominance of the parallel bus began to wane. Today, parallel buses are mostly relegated to the internal workings of our devices. But now with connections like PCI Express, which is serial, even this is changing. So thank you for watching. And see you in the next video.